Welcome to The Math Planet, your fast math guide. Hi third graders, the title for today's lesson is Round Whole Numbers Using a Number Line. Are you ready to start? Hello everyone, today's lesson is about rounding, and in rounding we scale the number slightly up or down, so we don't get an exact or accurate measure, we get an estimate measure. And today we will use the number line for rounding. In the number line, we often have the lesser numbers to the left side of the number line and the greater numbers to the right side of the number line. And we will also have three benchmarks on the number line. Let's see an example to know the steps. How can we round 374 to the nearest 10? In order to round this number to the nearest 10, first I need to circle the tens digit, which is 7 in this example. Next, I will draw the number line. If I am concerned about the tens digit, this means I will replace any number to the right of the tens digit by zeros. So my lower benchmark will be 370, and the upper benchmark will be 10 digits more because I'm rounding to the nearest 10. So it will be 380. So I will locate the 370 and the 380, which are the lower and upper benchmarks. I will locate both of them on the number line. Next, I will also add the halfway number, which is 375. After this, I will put my number, which is 374, on the number line, and then I will round it. In this case, I will round it to 370 because 374 is closer to 370. So the answer is 370, and in this example, we rounded down to the lesser number. So the steps for rounding are as follows. If I need to use the number line to round, first I will determine the place value of the target digit, which is, for example, the tens digit. Next, I will draw the number line and add the lower, upper, and halfway benchmarks on it. Next, I will locate my number on the number line, and finally, I will round up or round down my number. What are the rules for rounding? Rule number one. If your number is located closer to the lower benchmark, round it down to the lesser number. Rule number two. If your number is located closer to the upper benchmark, round it up to the greater number. Rule number three. If your number is exactly at the halfway number, you will also round it up to the greater number. Hope you got it. Now let's solve one more example. Let's round 374 to the nearest 100. First, we will circle the hundreds digit, which is 3. Next, we need to replace all the digits to the right side by zeros. So my lower benchmark will be 300 and the upper benchmark will be 100 more because I'm rounding to the nearest 100. So the upper benchmark will be 400. So here's my number line with the lower and upper benchmarks. Next, I will locate my halfway number and put my number 374. I will notice it is closer to 400, so I will round it up to 400 and the answer will be 400. Now let's check whether you understood the lesson by solving some questions. Number 1. Wooden bakery bakes 362 loaves of bread each week. What is 362 rounded to the nearest 10? We need first to determine the place value, which is the tens digit in this example. So I will circle the tens digit and put an arrow to the right of it. This means that my lower benchmark is 360 and the upper benchmark is 10 more because I'm rounding to the nearest 10. So the upper benchmark is 370. So the answer could be C or D. Let's draw the number line and put the halfway number 365. Next, I will put 362. I will notice it is closer to the lower benchmark, which means that the correct answer is 360. Question number 2. At the town marathon, there were 450 runners. What is the number rounded to the nearest 100? So I have 450 runners and I need to round the number to the nearest 100. So I will circle the place value digit, which is the hundreds digit in this problem. Next, I will determine my benchmarks. The lower benchmark will be 400 and the upper benchmark is 500. 450 is the halfway number. So this means I will round it up to 500 and the correct answer will be D. Now let's solve the last question. What is 497 rounded to the nearest 10? First, I will circle the place value for the 10th digit, which is the 9, and put an arrow to the right of it. So this means my lower benchmark is 490 and the upper benchmark is 10 more. But already the 10th digit has 9, so I will circle the 49 tenths and add one more 10. It will be 50 tenths or 500. So on the number line, I will put 490 as my lower benchmark and 500 as the upper benchmark, and the halfway number is 495. Then I will locate 497. 497 is closer to 500. So the correct answer will be 500, and I will round up the number to 500. To sum up today's lesson, today we learned how to round whole numbers using a number line. If your number is closer to the lower benchmark on the number line, you will round the number down to the lesser number. If your number is closer to the upper benchmark, you will round your number up to the greater number. And if your number is exactly at the halfway number, you will also round your number up to the greater number. This is the end of today's lesson. Thanks for watching. Hope you like the video. Please subscribe for more videos. See you later. Bye.